In this slide, you can look our results. The bridge for our students from our Rudan University, special education for telemedicine, and some other experience for collaboration with Germany, with some other countries, including the multi-point video conference. Some words about our experience. We started the telemedical project 20 years ago. I was the chief of telemedical department in the Buffalo Center for Cardiovascular Surgery, and every year we had nearly 1,000 distant video consultations, including the video consultation for newborns with congenital heart disease, and so on. Of course, we have no good channels at this time, and we use the ISDN integrated service digital network. It's special protocol and very simple equipment based on the usual computers. And we use the simple video conference by Intel company, but we had not so bad results because we have possibilities for real video consultation face to face, and also we had possibilities for discussion results of investigations. We can look at the EKG, X-ray, and so on. Also, here you can look at our first experience for distant video consultation with far Russian region, Yakutia, 6,000 kilometers, and it far, of course. And also, it was our first experience for distant video consultation for children with congenital heart disease. After this video consultation, we can receive this patient for real operation on the open heart. Here you can look our modern results. We have big experience for distance education, and in this patient, in this slide, you can look our result in real-time transmission of different kinds of operation, including the operation on the open heart. We have a very famous cardiac surgeon, Kadim Bakira, and in this picture you can look to real operation. Of course, we have some special project for stereo images. I have very big experience in the real operating room in the cardiovascular image, and I know the real problem. If I want to receive new knowledge, such as young surgeon, I cannot do it because the head of surgeon cannot help me with this equation. But of course, we have the standard decision. We can use the little video camera on the helm of surgeon. But in this situation, we can receive only the head screen. And we have special project for special help for surgeon with two simple and little video camera. But it's not so bad because we have the real stereo images, we have the full HD quality, and we can send these images, stereo images, to the other room, to the other town, to the other country. It's our project with special agreement and so on. I hope in the end of this year, maybe in the beginning of the next year, we can install this decision in the Curie Oncology Institute in Paris and in two operating rooms in the Regensburg University. Here you can look our experience for international telesymposium or international teleconference in France with Institute of Curie in Germany, with Germany, with Regensburg University, with France, with Strasbourg University, and with Sorbonne University, and with Canada. We have some friends who have big experience in the forest regions in the area. Of course, we would like to work together with our friends with India. In this picture, you can look three Professor Mishra. I hope all are now my friends. And we have real experience for real-time transmission of some operations, some special education for our students. It's very interesting, very useful for us, because in the Rudent University, we have students from 52 countries. From India, not more, I think 10 when you travel, not more. Here you can look our experience in the distance video consultation. I want to say that really, that video consultation is not discussion to physicians face to face. During video consultation, we can discuss all information about patients because we want to prepare the real result. We must prepare the good treatment. We must prepare the good perspective for patients. It is necessary to make operation, maybe not. Maybe we can prepare the very simple manipulation. We have special decisions, special experience for far Russian region, where we cannot use the standard video conferencing. Here you can look our experience in the temperate village, namely the Ice Ocean. Of course, in this situation, we cannot use the standard video conference equipment, and we can use only the mobile decision together with satellite equipment. Of course, we can use in this situation only in WhatsApp equipment, because we can prepare this equipment for real work during 20 to 10 minutes. And I want to say that really, this decision can help us with multi-point video conference. Here you can look the video conference near the Ice Ocean in the temporary village. Here you can look my face in Moscow. Here you can look our physician from the Salihar Regional Hospital. And here you can look physician in the temporary village. Here you can look our experience in the winter. The same situation is Yamal, it's north of Russia. -30, and physicians take part in the video conference after special travel by helicopter. And here the same situation, of course, during summer. In Russia, we have special decision. You know, we have already country, and from Sakhalin to the Kaliningrad, nearly 12,000 kilometers. And we have special decision, medical training. In Russia, we have in the Russian railways, we have 5 medical trains which we can use in the forest region, where people sometimes never look physician. It's true, because to the distance between little village and big town with big hospital, sometimes 400, maybe 500 kilometers. And we have special medical trains such as polyclinic with good medical devices with good medical equipment. And in this medical train, we have telemedicine. We have special satellite equipment on the train. And we have the video conference equipment in this train too. And we can prepare the telebridge with multiple video conference if necessary. If need is to discuss some questions about our patients with Moscow, with some big regional hospital, and maybe connection with Japan, maybe with Germany, maybe with India, not so difficult. Of course, we have some problems with satellite equipment only in the mountains, but it's clear. Now, the same project we can look in the Kazakhstan. Our friend from Kazakhstan has now to the same train after our project. Here you can look our experience with the ambulance. The same idea, we have the video conference equipment in the ambulance and physical physician, and we have the satellite equipment in WhatsApp, satellite equipment on the ambulance. It's very important because we can prepare the telebridge, we can prepare the video conference during moving. It's very important because we cannot say, please stop, I want to discuss with good neurosurgeon, problems about patient and so on. We cannot take the hands of our patient. Here you can look our special decision for place of catastrophe. It's video conference which we can use together with satellite equipment and the place of catastrophe in the forest region. We can start to work with this project after 15 minutes in 20 minutes. I want to say that we have additional decision for this mobile video conference equipment to special help. Special help with the ability for transfer the video and audio. It's very important because I can go from our video conference equipment with this special help. I think really our experience 2 kilometers. Next. Of course, we have experience in the space, you know. Some of my chief, Radek Rashkov, Israel astronaut, many years ago, he was in the space 9 months, such a physician. And 10 years ago, we had special project together with the European Space Agency, health medical support in the space, in the Russian segment of the space station. Here you can look our experience, our investigation. Of course, I was on the ground in the space station. Here is special equipment in the space, for space. And here you can look at the space station from. And here, I had a very difficult experience for me, special field for astronauts. And here you can look our friend from Mainz University. He helped us with some investigation for telemedical support. Of course, we have some experience with home telemedicine now because it's very interesting in Russia. And we have special platform, ResNet, in English, in Russian, in German, in many languages. And here you can look our results for special education. I want to say that, of course, we can stand, we can install many different equipment, very rich equipment in the big and little hospital. But if our physicians have no real experience, have no understanding how they can use this equipment, how they can prepare the real video consultation and the real-time transmission of some manipulations and operations, we cannot receive good results. And some years ago, we started special education for students and for physicians in telemedicine. Special course, nearly 66, maybe 72 sometimes, hours. 1 week, maybe 2 weeks. We have some different courses. And during this education, we can prepare some lectures of my friends from India, from Brazil, from Canada, from America, from China, and from Europe, of course. It's very interesting education because for me and for our students too, because after this education, they can receive the real experience in telemedicine. Not only the theoretical knowledge, but real practical knowledge. Because without examination, my students and physicians must have a real video consultation. Problems, of course, we have problems because during this examination, during the preparation of this examination, all students must be professors. Nobody wants to be the patient and young physician. It's a real picture of our education for students. You can look the real situation. Here, our students from here said that we want to prepare the real-time transmission of operation. Here, our students from Africa, from Sudan, during the examination. Here, our students from gastroenterology. And here, our students want to show me some special investigation. Last slide of my presentation, you can look at my students. from different cultures. And later, first of all, I want to show you a little video.